all people ever see is the 15 minutes in the cage. They don't see the 8 weeks leading up where getting up early to go on a 10 kilometer run on an empty stomach. Then driving 30 miles to Cardiff to do boxing with Gary Lockett, and then driving 30 miles back to do a jiu-jitsu session, and then the next day driving 30 miles to Cardiff to do a strength and conditioning with his fitness coach, Greg Carlo. All these things take its toll, not just physically, but mentally as well. Said even back then, you boys stick with me and I'll get one of us in. From as young as 7 years of age. I think our oldest student is in his mid-50s. We've got all walks of life. We've had police officers, firemen, bank managers, training alongside guys that's been referred to me from the Youth Offending Service, guys that's been in prison or at risk of getting to that point in their life. And it's brilliant, you know, there's a lot of good role models within the club for some of the youngsters and some of the guys that's on the wrong road to look up to and do well with themselves. Some come here for one or two nights a week, they just want a bit of fitness and a little bit of self-defence. You've got others that take it a little bit serious, they want the competition but not quite the stress and the tribulation of fighting MMA, so you've got your BJJ, your Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu team, and then obviously you've got your dedicated professionals and unified amateur guys that fight. But we've got, like I said, lads that are here 5-6 days a week, 2-3 times a day sometimes, you know. But they share the mat with the guys that come in once or twice a week and just want to do a bit of fitness, you know. It's much easier for a young man that's living at home with their parents who set their heart on becoming a professional fighter, and that's what they're dedicating their life to do. They've got all the time in the world to do it without having to worry about the mortgage, putting food on the table for the kids. Well, you can't expect that same sort of commitment from your family man who's married, working a 40-hour shift in the factory, and then you can't expect him to be coming here 5 days a week. So we put no limits on anybody. All we ask is that they come in, get on with everybody. When they are here, they train hard and listen. And enjoy it, really.
20 seconds, Jake.
One of the most pleasing things as a coach for me to see is watching a person grow. I'm fortunate, I'm within our ninth year, so I've seen some lads that have come from, you know, they were in school when they joined me, and they turned into really decent young men, you know, and young women for that matter. You know, I've got a couple of girls like Caitlin that's been with me since she was 12, 13 years of age. She's in her 20s now. It's fulfilling for me, not just a martial arts, like just watching people grow as individuals, as human beings. You know, there's a lot of lads that have come here with really bad reputations. A lot of people would have crossed the road probably, not, you know, to avoid them, not to actually walk past them on a Saturday night. And just to watch how they've turned themselves around, how they've used the gym to channel their energy into something positive and feed off the good vibes that some of the good role models in the club give.
Yeah, boys, can we get them up? Grab them up, give me a shout, Paul.
Yeah, just watching the fucking session, aren't you?
Yeah.
Watching the session.
Come on.
Sat down with him.
Jack's pretty laid back as a competitor. He's been doing it so long. You see some of the interviews he does, he always says, well, I don't really feel nerves. And I've always said, everybody feels nerves, but he controls them really well. If he does, he doesn't show it. From a very young age, he's just been in love with the sport. He's trained 5 nights a week for as long back as I can remember. There's never been a time where I've made him go training, you know? There's never been a time where I've said, get your backside in gear, you need to get up there. It's all been off his own back, you know? So it's something that he loves. And a lot of people probably do assume, oh, it was the pushy father syndrome. And I can assure you it's not. If he had said to me when he was 15, 16, he was a good rugby player. He started playing rugby at 15, and within a year, he was captain of the local side. And I encouraged him with the rugby, used to take the rugby, take him training. I got involved with the rugby side of it. And I think he was about 16, 17, and he just won the British Jiu-Jitsu Championships in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu at a juvenile. And he says to me, Dad, I can't do the both. I don't want to be good at two things. I want to be brilliant at one.
Trying to warm your lungs up, shit.
Right, watch it in, boys. Tackle throw one. I'll throw
two. He's the most unassuming fighter we've got at the gym, probably. You wouldn't give him a second look on the street, the way he conducts himself. He's much more intelligent than I was. I mean, I've encouraged him to go to university. In the second year of university, we were at loggerheads with he wanted to quit and focus solely on the fighting career. And it took a bit of persuading, but I wanted him to finish his degree because this sport is short-lived. And you know, next week you could break your leg or break your neck and you can't fight no more, so you need to have a backup plan. Well, he stuck at it, qualified, he passed his degree. The last 12 months he's really developed, as a professional athlete. He's training 3 times a day, 6 days a week. And it's discipline. I'm not just saying it because he's my lad. I mean, he's more disciplined than anybody I've worked with. You know, if you ask him to do something, he does it, follows it through 100%. His diet in, not just the training, the diet in. You know, he's a young lad with a good circle of friends that enjoy a night out. And he can go out and drink water if he does, or he's quite happy to sit in the house and avoid it for the 8 weeks leading up to the camp. And he's very driven. As much as an unassuming character he is, he's very, very strong-minded. He's got a real self-belief in him. This is something he's wanted to do from a very, very young age. And he's starting to see the fruits of his labour, really. 12-0 as an amateur, he's 4-0 now as a professional. He's got a really, really tough fight on Saturday. There's no bones about it. This will really dictate to just at what level he is, and people will start taking notice based on the result of this next fight. So the last 2 weeks, you'll see a little bit of a... Yeah, I suppose focus is a key word. The final week then, he starts getting a little bit quieter. You see, he's not it's not a good place to be when you're cutting weight. He's very driven, he's watching a lot more videos of the opponent, he's starting to analyse him together. The reality that you're going to be in a fight is starting to sink at home. I've always said it's thinking about fighting, thought of the battle is worse than the battle itself. Not just that, it's the environment. For example, if I put somebody in the training cage in the gym with two or three people, there's no nerves, they don't lose any sort of focus, they're committed to the battle, they spar really hard for three rounds, they don't get tired. But if you change the environment and put 1,000 people around them with friends and family and girlfriends, and the expectation and the pressures follow because all the press has said this is the next big thing and this kid's going to be the next guy from Wales to get into the UFC, then you've got to see a different beast.
Graham, many European countries with a deep talent pool, but Wales particularly is starting to bubble up.
We've got Jack Shore fighting Commander, huge step up for him. We've got Josh Reed fighting Gavin Kelly, got a local Welsh boy who's got a really good record at the moment. And then we step into Lou Long in the main event fighting Shane Mills. So there's a lot of talent coming out of this country, and these guys are going to do well tonight, taking over the card.
We have Damo Reed in the blue corner. This should be an interesting bout. And it was getting pushed backwards immediately here by Sweden's coming out.
It's not a natural process to watch your son go out and fight. Without blowing no trouble, I think one of the best cornermen in the business. But I find it really, really difficult when it's Jack, because it's not always professional. Sometimes the father-son thing comes in rather than the coach fight. But it's difficult to get that balance on times. You know, Chris Reese once said, when he watched Jack, and he was explaining to people, there's probably better boxers out there in the world, there's probably better grapplers out there in the world, there's probably better wrestlers, but there's not many to put it together in the way that he does.
Good job. Yes, sir. Yes. Anti.